Hello, this is Damon Pistolka with the Exit Your Way Roundtable, where we talk with business professionals about different topics that will help people grow businesses and make them run better. And today I'm really happy because I've got Brad Smith with Stellar Insight with us, and we're going to talk about creating extreme growth. Hey, Brad, I'm glad to have you here. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Good to be here. So I'm Brad Smith. My company is Stellar Insight, Inc. I've been coaching CEOs and business owners for 23 years, maybe 24, getting close to it. And one of the things that I dearly love is finding out what the limitations of growth are in their particular situation. It's a combination of industry and situation specific.
Okay.
I love that dearly because I've literally made millionaires. I mean, that just makes me happy.
Nice. So it's really cool to talk to you today about extreme growth because, you know, I talked to a lot of coaches that are doing, you know, revenue generation, whatever you want to talk about. But there's one thing that you talk about that always sticks in my mind, and that's adding a zero to someone's sales. Because that's big.
It is. And it's something that I like to find out in the first half hour to 45 minutes that I talk to them. I find out, we literally have them go through the whole conversation about their business, what works, what doesn't work. And I'm constantly asking, what are the restrictions to growth in your company? And there's only like five or six areas. The first one I start with is, what's the industry you're in? And I've literally had two companies have been able to add at least a zero to their income, right?
Wow, that's cool.
My normal process is you go in and you find out where they're at and what their mindset is, right? And if they can only achieve, let's say over the last 5 years, they've been able to achieve 10% growth, right? Well, my goal is to take whatever they've been able to do and figure out how I can get them to a minimum of 100% growth a year. And that's not just 1 year. That's like teach them and their organization how to grow 100% a year, year over year over year, right? And just set them up that way.
Yeah.
But there are a few situations where I can go in and that conversation brings us out to, well, you know, we're at, you know, $3 million a year right now, or we're at $20 million a year right now. And in the conversation, this has happened repeatedly, where I will listen to them and roll over something they haven't paid any attention to. And I'm saying, stop, look at that right there. Look at that piece right there. If that were active in your company, that would mean you could do 100 to 200 to 300% growth this year, right?
Yeah,
I had one of those, and in 3 years we achieved 27 a rate of growth from, you know, 1 year to the following. We increased their rate of growth on an annual basis by 2,700%.
Wow.
2,700%.
Wow, that's crazy. So the thing that really intrigues me about this is a lot of this has to do simply with mindset.
That's the first piece. The first piece is what's possible and what's on the other side of that comfort zone.
Okay. Right?
So that's the first thing I have to get is to change them in their perspective to say, if that's possible, I want that. Right. So it takes ambition and curiosity. So after they've broken through that limitation wall, then it's, you know, like with the one company, the 2,700%, we changed two of the top officers, and I apologize, but we had to, right? We plugged in new people that had more ambition and capacity for growth, a different mindset. So the executive team has to have what's the question plugged into their brain, what's possible, and we're going to achieve it.
Okay.
So the mindset is first, then the people are second, right? And behind that then is the financial and the production, whether it's a service industry or a manufacturing company, doesn't matter, what's the production capacity for? And normally the slower limitations are not the sales, not the marketing, and not even the mindset of the people at the top. The things that slow down growth are, what's your financial capacity to fund the growth, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
That's actually a hard place that you run into. And it's like, once it's there, you can evolve that, right?
Yeah.
You can grow that, but there's only, you know, if your EBITDA is, you know, $10 million a year, you can only get so much in the way of, you know, loan capacity to do that.
Yeah. Yeah. We run into it with our clients when we start and we grow too hard, especially when you're talking about, well, it could be a product-based company or a manufacturing company, especially if it's equipment dependent. And some of the manufacturing companies, you do hit those limitations pretty quickly. Whereas that I could see that being a bit of a challenge, because as you said, you only can scale so quickly because your lending capacity is not there. And you know, equipment, usually you can make that work, but when you talk about if I'm a product-based company and I just sell more products and it's on a 30-day term for some reason, say it's a B2B type thing, that what most business owners don't realize until it bites them is that accounts receivable grows because their business is bigger. That's dollars. Those are dollars sitting out there. And the line of credits need to get bigger because they've got to cover that receivable for those 30 days. And in your case, if you're going, you know, 27X on that, I could have $1 million accounts receivable 1 year, and the next year it would be $27 million if we just did 2700%. That's a huge challenge.
It is.
Yeah.
So, but behind everything, even that, the key piece, one of the key limiters that I found, and I started addressing about 9 years ago, is hiring. Getting quality people in and having the skills inside your company to be able to hire people at the proper level, right? So the first thing I work on is attitude. The second thing I work on is the character of the individual that I'm working with at the top of the organization. And then the organization's ability to recognize the character of their company. After they recognize the character of their company and design it appropriately,
yeah,
then attracting people into that, like, I don't want to work for that company, right? But you've got to have, it costs 3 to 4 times as much, sometimes 15 times as much. Hire somebody, it costs you 15 times their salary, certainly 3 times their salary to have them go away. So hiring is the net. And if you do a good job of hiring quality people, then you can grow your company. And that actually is the biggest limiter, but that's just the people capacity.
Yeah. Yeah. So, well, it's Jim Collins and Good to Great. I mean, he talks about getting the right people on the bus. And if you have the right people, you don't need to motivate them because it's inside of them what they need to do. And it is totally true. So that's cool that you're bringing that up. And it is one of the, you know, tried and true things in business. If you can hire better than everyone else, you're probably going to have a good business because of it.
Yep. A players, B players, C players, only hire A players. So my rule of thumb is this. If you hire sevens on a scale from 1 to 10, if you hire a 7, the most you can grow somebody is 2 points. You can get them to a 9, right?
Okay.
If you hire a 7.5, you can get a 9.5, right?
Yeah.
But they have to want it, they have to be committed to it, and they have to drive it as hard as you have to. But two clicks, sometimes you can grow somebody 2.5 points, but that's it, right?
Okay. Well, that's a good thing to know, you know, because there's a lot of people that really, I believe, I'm not going to use the right words, but they just put up with the fact that they're not good at hiring and they're going to hire B and C players.
That crushes me.
yeah. That's a great thing. So it starts with A, the mindset, B, really figuring out what is possible, and C, making sure you've got the right people to execute to that vision. Well, that's cool. It's awesome. It's awesome to talk to you about this. I always get excited when we talk about growth. It's been, you know, we've known each other for a while now. It's great just learning more about it and hearing how you do this with businesses.
Well, and the thing, what blows me away is almost every business owner or CEO that I talk to already has the information inside their head. It's already there. There's a few times where I will pick stuff up that they don't know, but almost always they already know. It's just me reflecting questions back at them. The other thing that I do is I listen below what they're understanding and around what they're understanding, and I look for the gaps in their understanding. It's like if they understand 80% of it, I want to understand the 20% they don't understand and bring in the questions so that their curiosity gets piqued and they start driving into the unknown, because the unknown is where the zeros happen.
There you go. The unknown is where the zeros happen. That's great. That's really cool. Because it's just fascinating when you look at, like you said, there are so many people know what they need to do or are afraid to take the step, even though they know what they need to do. Do you find that's a lot of it, is they know what they need to do, but they're just, for whatever reason, not doing it?
Well, it's the perspective. The question, that's a good question. Almost all good business owners, I'd say only 10 to 15% of them are afraid. The other 80 to 85% of them aren't afraid to take the steps, but they haven't figured out how to link everything together. The other thing is most people own jobs. They don't own businesses.
Yeah.
If they own a job, they're in what, you know, Jim Collins called, or what was it, Stephen Covey called, quadrant ones, urgent and important. And if you live in quadrant one, you cannot grow a company. If you spend half your time in quadrant two, which is not urgent, but important, that's the strategic planning quadrant. If you learn to live in that, which is a third of the work I do, is teaching people how to live there with their mind, and then drop into quadrant one when they have to, right? And design there. And I've got a set of exercises I take people through to get them out of quadrant one into quadrant two. That right there is the difference between growing at 10% and growing at 50% a year. That right there.
Wow. That's really, really telling as to what just them understanding what daily they should be doing can make a huge difference.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Brad, it's been great just to catch up with you a little bit and talk about this subject. And again, it's just so exciting to me to hear you and some of the wisdom that you've laid down for us today. If someone wants to talk to you and get a hold of you, what's the best way to do that?
My website is stellarinsightinc.com. There's a way to schedule directly onto my calendar there. Or you can call me at 360-260-0138.
Okay. Well, it's been great to have you again. We had Brad from Stellar Insight Inc. here today talking to us about creating extreme growth in a business. And I will have the comments, I will have his contact information as well if you didn't catch it in the video. But thanks again, Brad, and I'm sure we'll have you back soon.
Thank you. Take care, Dan.
Bye.